Eat, sleep, rave, repeat. So I'm rocking this gear from the shop that was free. I thought I'd take the time to make this video is to talk about a little bit about the evolution of NetherRealms. Now, I've been a day one player. Some people probably don't even know. I played since the beta. I haven't played on it. You just jumped on it because it was new or just heard about it from watching other people's videos or anything like that. I played from finding out from a fan who told me about the release when this game came out from October 2016. And the game has come so far. And I made a video similar to this, but it's a lot different now. We have additional. We just recently have a new space. It's the Raid space that's right over there. And just look at the number of spaces we have. And just to, before I even get to that, look at the Nexus. The Nexus was never like this. And some people probably don't even know. I have old, old parts where they were, the spaces were a lot further. It was a lot bigger part of the Nexus. It wasn't, the spaces weren't as close as they are right now. It looked so different. And I said this before in one of my recent parts and older parts. You would literally have to be lucky to even stay on for 5 minutes. And then just in a matter of time, me just standing here right now, just trying to run around, you would lag really badly and you would crash. And then your application would crash as well. You would get a blue screen, all types of stuff, have to try to restart, and then you would never be able to get back on because the service was just that bad. And what people don't really know about this game is that the developers literally had to start over. They had to start over from the beginning and rebuild the whole game from the ground up, take it off the PlayStation Store where everyone remember it was accessible from the PlayStation Store where you can download for free. They had to take it off the PlayStation Store for a good while because they had to rebuild it. They had to redo everything because it was basically unplayable. You couldn't even come on here and play and load in and even stay on for a few minutes without crashing. You'll get stuck in different spots. You'll be glitched out, going through all types of different obstacles. Like, I was stuck at Leaf Park for a good while. I didn't even know how to get unstuck until they came out with a feature to get your avatar unstuck just in case you glitched out or if you couldn't load back in. It was all types of issues going on. Now, let's look at the number of spaces we have here. Just starting from the Nexus here. Because this place looks way different. And if you go back and look in some of the old videos, it definitely has changed and has come a long way. Even with the, even way prior to this Unity update that we have now. So just count the spaces that we have. So we got the Nexus. Let's start with Leap Park. So because that was one of the next spaces that you could go to. So this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you want to count it, 7, 8, and then we have 9. But this still says Stone Lake Castle, so they probably have to fix this. So you can basically say, if you don't want to count the personal apartment, which they still have to come out with updates for the furniture and everything like that, you could probably say 8.5 to 9 spaces, if you like. It depends on the player. Maybe 8.5 spaces in total or 9 spaces. And I'm sure there's going to be a lot to come this year, but we didn't have all this stuff, because in the beginning, we had just the Nexus, the huge Nexus, and then we had just the Leaf Park, and then the bowling alley eventually came available. But from it was the Nexus, then it was the Leaf Park, and then it was the nightclub or the dome, whatever you want to call it. And then a little bit after that, we had the bowling alley, and then we had the beach. And it was one of these in between afterwards. Then we had the Halloween space, Stone Lake Castle. Now we got the Raid space. So we have all this different type of content, different shops, where you can purchase all types of things. I think we have much better servers, and it's even more public because everyone can play. You download the game. You don't even have to pay for it. You can just download it. And then if you don't like it, maybe you don't like it, you're coming in as a first-time player, you don't have to keep the game because you can't lose. It's not like you're buying a game for like buying a $60 game and say, oh man, I got to take it back, try to trade it in, get your money back. You can just download it and just try it out for yourself. You don't have to buy anything off the store, use crystals and whatnot. You can check it out, experience it for yourself, and then decide whether or not you like it. We have different, just 6 different areas of space of content that you can pick and choose from. So there's no way you can really lose unless you decide to spend money in the game and then you just decide to stop playing it out of nowhere. You can do whatever you want to do. play it how you want to, and if you don't like it, just delete it. You can't really lose. But I know it's probably some people probably say, oh, well, it's an amateur version of PlayStation Home. This game will never catch up and be like PlayStation Home. This is a whole different team behind the game. This is a smaller team. These guys aren't Sony, where they had all these, cause they had a huge team where they can get out updates in a quick amount of time. They definitely have come so far, even being a small development team. And the potential behind this game is really huge. And there's so much that we can do, the game that can add. But the one thing I can say is that it needs more multiplayer games. We need more stuff. And I said this before, I'm headed right there over here in this direction where the Chrome Racer minigame is. This should have been multiplayer. This should have been one of the first multiplayer games and one of the additional multiplayer games, because the best multiplayer game right now is over at the bowling alley where you can bowl up to four people. Everything else, it's one-on-one action where it's just tic-tac-toe at the Stone Club, the Stone Lake Castle, tic-tac-toe, chess, and what was the other one? Checkers. That's the other one. Those are all just up to two players max. But the other mini games like this could have been up to four players, where you can race against each other. And yeah, the controls are really tough and just difficult when it comes to controlling the different types of vehicles that you can pick to. I think it was like up to three different ones you could pick. It controls are really difficult. But just looking at it now, it's a better game. And if people want better graphics, I don't think we're probably going to get any better than what it is right now since we got the Unity update. I'm not a graphics gamer, never been one, because I play all the classic games from the 90s, from Sega Genesis, retro games and stuff. And it's more than about the graphics to me when it comes to a video game. Because in the end, if the game's fun, it's going to be good. It can be good, even if it doesn't look the best. But everybody's different. Even if this isn't your type of game. But in the comparison, I gotta say, Four Kings Casino and Adam Universe, this is the best game out of the three, in my opinion. Because if you are a PlayStation Home fan, or maybe someone who played it a lot and loved it, you're gonna like this game a little bit more. And I think this is gonna be the closest and has the most potential to be just like PlayStation Home. Based on all the updates we had since, I literally just seen this game just grow and just evolve. So I'm happy to see all the updates. So I'm gonna head to the beach and check it out over there, because this is one of my favorite spaces in the game. So one thing we do need, we just need more music. We got new music at the Ray space, which is cool, but we need more extra music. We need more mini games to play, even more activities, so we're not just standing around chit-chatting. I know it's a social game, but still, you want to probably have fun and just mess around, have some fun with some mini games and whatnot. But bowling, the bowling alley is the best place when it comes to the best multiplayer mini games, because you got pinball. I mean, you got pool, but pool is up to two players. You would think more than one person would be able to play, but when people really play against each other in real life in pool, it's usually like one versus one. So this place, we didn't have all this stuff just to share even more. It's a beautiful game. It's fun. You can connect with people all over the world, get to know them. And if they have similar games to you, like me, some of you guys play Fortnite. Everybody's playing Fortnite since that game's literally taking over. You might even find fellow Fortnite players, maybe people who love Call of Duty, and maybe some similar games that you guys play together, get to know each other, team up. And maybe you're looking for someone to get a dual win, for example, for Fortnite, a squad win. You maybe need a fourth player, or maybe some people to play with on some of these other multiplayer games that you guys play. You can come on the rounds and connect with people to see what kind of games you have. They might have. Chat it up, bring up the different games that you have, and maybe if you're looking for someone to team up with, you can probably meet some new people around the world, regardless of where they're from. So I think that's a pretty cool aspect about this game. But I'm sure you can do it probably in Four Kings and Adam Universe, but I just personally like this game better. And I don't think I would ever go back to because I never even touched those games or downloaded them, Four Kings Casino or Adam Universe at all, because I just personally will stick with Nebula all the way, because I think this is for us PlayStation Home players and fans who came on here for this main particular reason, because you get that feeling. I get this feeling from playing the game. I got the feeling from playing it since day one. So I'm happy with the evolution of the game, which is the different spaces you can go to. Ghost Town is literally a ghost town, but no one really goes there. But hopefully they'll probably add something there for this year's Halloween, or maybe it'll do something different. But we just need more spaces, well, more activities. We got our recent space, but this, the raid space, needs an activity. We need more stuff. And it, when I go there, it makes me think of the dome. And I'm gonna head there really quickly before I wrap this up. But just all the changes that they done, they rebuilt this game from the ground up, had to literally take it off the PlayStation Store, and then more players, as it got better, as the servers got more stable, the crashes stopped, more people were able to come on here to make changes to their character, get access to the wardrobe, because it was literally a death trap to even try to get to the wardrobe. See? And then some, just, it looks almost similar to it. Besides the smiley faces and stuff like that, smiley faces, hearts, and then the alien heads that would come up. We just got music notes and just different music playing, the same just original music that comes on when you go to different spaces. It makes me think of it a lot, just with the colors and all that. It looks identical to it. It's like the brand new dome, but they should bring more to it. I hope they do, to the raid space. Maybe some activities, because that'll make it a little bit different, because you can't do anything here except dance. You can sit out here at the bar. But that when people said they brought up the bar, we already have that here. I know, I'm floating. Look, I'm not even sitting on a chair. It'll look almost similar to this. They should bring something else there. They could just bring some other activities. I was saying like a mini arcade. Remember that arcade, the bowling alley? Back at PlayStation Home, they should put a little mini arcade where you can play some mini games. Maybe some mini game, multiplayer mini games. Because the bowling alley in PlayStation Home had the arcade, they had pool, and they had bowling all in one. And I think it was something else that you could do. I forgot. It's just so many things that they had in there. But I'm happy with the changes. I'm happy with the growth of this game. It's definitely grown, and a lot of you guys are coming on here to play, to experience the game. Plus it's free, so you can't really, again, you can't lose from experiencing a game that's free. And if you don't like it, you can just delete it. You don't have to ever go back to it. You can delete it for good, delete it forever, and go play something else. Maybe you like 4 Kings, because you know that's your cup of tea. Maybe you like Atom Universe, if that's what you like a little bit better. It depends on the person. And I know about the VME update that they added to Atom Universe, but I'm not gonna just jump on a game because a company from the PlayStation Home Days decided to jump on there. That's gonna not make me wanna make the switch. I'm sticking with the game that I stuck with, because the game actually has grown, evolved, and has changed, and it gets better and better and better, even with the updates. So it of course it had its downfalls, and I was there during the beginning when it was falling off and everybody stopped playing it, and then now people are jumping on it now because all the new updates are on here. They have a reason to play it because there's new stuff to come on here for. And it's getting even more populated. And see, now I can get between space to space. You couldn't do this from before. It's pretty crazy. So as I load up here at the park, now is there something in particular I would like to see them bring back here? Not necessarily. They can do what they want to do. They can add what they want to add. And I think as long as it's new, it's gonna be good. It'll continue to keep people to play. As long as they continue to bring stuff here, there's even more people here at the Leaf Park. This was never here. But let me know how you guys are liking the game. Comment on the video if you guys want to.